In business statistics, in this lesson, we will be looking into the regression equations, that is calculation of regression equations through regression coefficients. That is, again calculated, regression coefficients are again calculated by using the assumed mean and also actual mean. And we'll also see some properties of regression coefficients in this lesson. So the main objectives of this lesson are, on completion of this lesson, a student will be able to understand the properties of regression coefficients, formulas for finding regression equations through regression coefficients by taking deviations from assumed mean. And we will also see the formula and some examples by taking deviations from actual mean also. So these two methods are very useful in calculating these regression coefficients, because in direct method the solution of the problem will be more lengthy and more tedious also, because when some fractions come, some decimal points come in the solution, then it becomes very complex for calculating the problem. So even with the usage of calculators, a student may feel difficult and very lengthy in solving these problems. So to overcome that method, that disadvantage or demerits, the shortcut method, that is deviations taken from actual mean or assumed mean, are used for calculating the regression coefficients and finding regression equations. Of course, in the earlier lessons also, in arithmetic mean, in calculation of arithmetic mean, in calculation of standard deviation, in calculation of correlation, we have seen both direct method and shortcut method. And we know the difficulty and complex of the problems when we solve them by using direct method. So the shortcut method may be preferred in solving these problems. First of all, we will look into these methods so that you can appreciate their method of calculating coefficients, regression coefficients, and finding the regression equations. In the last lesson, as I said, the direct method involves more calculations and it consumes more time. And if the data is given, it will become very worse for calculating the things because it is very tedious, very strain your mind to find out regression equation by using this method. So this method is not much in use because of the demerits associated with this method. Now we will see about the calculation of regression equations by taking actual means and assumed means. So before going into the methods of calculating the regression coefficients and finding the regression equations, we will look into the properties of regression coefficients. So we will look into the properties. What are the properties existing? First one is both regression coefficients Bxy and Byx should not exceed 1. That means Bxy and Byx multiplied will get correlation square. So the correlation square must not exceed 1, or the square root of r square, that is r, should never exceed 1 because the correlation value always lies between minus 1 and plus 1. So the maximum value for a negative correlation is minus 1 and the maximum value for positive correlation is plus 1. And as far as regression equations are concerned, for two variables, x and y, we will be having two equations. That is two regression equations. One is regression equation of x on y, and the other one is regression equation of y on x. So the regression lines will be regression line of x on y minus regression line of x on y on x, that is most probable values of y for given value of x, that is x is independent value and y is dependent value. and regression line of x on y. That is most probable value of x for given value of y. For given value of y. That is given value is dependent, independent, and the other value is dependent. So we'll see these two regression equations in this lesson. Now coming to the regression equation of x on y. X on y is x is dependent and y is independent. That means when the y value is given, then we will find out the corresponding value of x, right? Depending on the value of y only, the value of x depends. So in these two, one will be independent and one will be dependent. So y is independent and x is dependent. X is arithmetic mean of x series, x bar. X bar is the formula is x minus x bar is equal to r into standard deviation of x by standard deviation of y into y minus y bar, where x bar is arithmetic mean of x series and y bar is arithmetic mean of y series. So r into standard deviation of x by standard deviation of y is called regression coefficient. So this coefficient we will use for finding this equation. This is most important part, calculating or finding the regression coefficient, r standard deviation of x by standard deviation of y. This is more important. And this is denoted, this is symbolized by Bxy. Now regression equation of y on x. We have seen x on y. This is y on x. That is, this is dependent here. This is independent here. Whereas this is independent here. This is dependent here. And this is independent here. So the equation will be opposite to this. You please compare these two equations. X on y means first x will come. This way also you can remember. Y on and y will come after that. So first x will come and second y will come. Here also first y will come and here x will come. And you can also compare the regression coefficients also. x on y, first x standard deviation of x divided by standard deviation of y. Y on x, reverse of this, that is standard deviation of y by standard deviation of x. Regression equation or regression coefficient, standard deviation of x by standard deviation of y is called regression coefficient of y on x. And it is also symbolized by BYX. So all this you have to remember. This is BXY. This is BYX. That also you can remember. So like this, you have to remember the formula and you have to remember the procedure also. Like this. Right? So you please try to understand these two formulas very well. Then you can easily attempt the problems. Here, you have to remember what is BXY and what is BYX. What is BXY and what is BYX? When deviations are taken from actual mean, there is no need to calculate coefficient of correlation, that is R, and standard deviation of X and standard deviation of Y. Please remember, if deviations are taken from actual mean, you need not calculate any of this. No need to calculate coefficient of correlation, sigma x, sigma y, because regression, the correlation into standard deviation of x, standard deviation of y, standard deviation of x divided by standard deviation of y is equal to bxy, that is sigma xy by sigma y square. Here small x, small y, sigma xy by sigma y square. So where x is x minus x bar, y is equal to y minus y bar. If you use this one, that is enough. So in place of this, we will substitute this, that is x minus x bar is equal to sigma xy by sigma y square into y minus y bar, if you substitute this in the form. Right, we will see in the problem how that is used. And if deviations are taken from assumed mean, that is direct mean, actual mean, if deviations are taken from assumed mean, we will take dx and dy, where dx is equal to x minus a and dy is equal to y minus a. That's all. So that in that way, the simplification of formula or the modification of the formula will be done. That means R into standard deviation of x by standard deviation of y is equal to bxy is equal to sigma dx dy minus sigma dx square into sigma dy by n. This by 1. This is the whole equation. This is divided by n. Here also, same thing. Okay? Right. So, n into sigma dx dy minus sigma dx sigma dy. Here also you can put bracket here so that you will understand. So by taking LCM and simplifying, you will get n into sigma dx dy minus sigma dx into sigma dy divided by n into sigma dy square minus sigma dy whole square. You can remember this formula. This is very important. Right? Next one. Where dx is equal to x minus a and dy is equal to y minus a. Here ax, that also I will clearly specify, because you have to remember everything. Here actually so this is ax, right? So you have to remember this one. If you remember this, then it will be okay. This is assumed mean of x series and this is assumed mean of y series. When deviations are taken from actual mean, regression equation of y on x, you can compare the formulas, that is very important, and you can remember very well. Here standard correlation into standard deviation of x by its standard deviation of y is equal to byx is equal to sigma xy by sigma x square, and the formula is byx is equal to sigma dx dy minus sigma dx into sigma dy by n. Here also you can mark like this. Here you have x square and sigma dx. In the previous formula, you have dy square dy whole square. That difference also you can observe. This y is this one. Okay? Y is used here and x is used here for y on x. So you can compare that one also. This x is compared like this. Okay? So the formula is like this. So we can remember like this. actually dx and dy should be written like this. Then only it will be correct. That is deviation of x, deviation of y, like this. Okay. Here also same thing. Of course, by mistake I have done that. Actually, in the formulas like this, we have to write like this only. This we have already seen in arithmetic mean. Same dx dy, which is used in arithmetic mean, standard deviation and correlation, same are used here also. Right. Next, calculation of correlation steps. Steps for calculation of correlation of regression coefficients and calculation of the correlation are same. With the help of two regression coefficients, correlation coefficient can be calculated. That means this one. This one. So as I said, in the introduction itself, R is root of bxy by byx. By means multiplication. R is equal to bxy into byx. So we'll take one example to understand this method. From the following data, obtain the two regression equations by taking deviations of x series from y, 5 and of y series from 7. That means 5 is mean of the deviations taken from, that is mean. (6 + 2 + 10 + 4 + 8) = 30. So divided by 6 is divided by 5. Is 6 actually, but this is taken for assumed mean. This is assumed mean. So in the same way, 7 is also assumed mean, that is 9 + 11 + 5 + 8 + 7. Again, this is also assumed mean. So by taking assumed mean, we will take an example. Then we will understand the procedure. Dx dy, because that is assumed mean. So x series, sigma x is 30 and sigma dx is +5. That is 6 - 5 + 1, 2 - 5 - 3, 10 - 5 + 5, 4 - 5 - 1, and 8 - 5 + 3. Like this, we have to calculate the deviations of x and deviations of y. Deviations of y also 9 - 7 = 2 + 2, 11 - 7 = 4, 5 - 7 - -2, 8 - 7 = -1, and 7 - 7 = 0. So dy square is 4 16 4 1 0. So dx dy is +1 × +2 = -3 × +4 - 12, +5 × 4 - 10, +5 × -2 - 10, and -1 × +1 - 1, plus 3 into 0 is 0. So we are calculating the dx dy from second and fifth column. Second into fifth column is dx dy, right? This is second column into second column. This is fifth column into fifth column. And we have got all the summations here, all the totals of all the columns. You please observe, we have taken the total of all the columns here. So by substituting the values sigma dx dy, so sigma dx dy is minus 21, sigma dx is 5, dy, sigma dy is 5, and divided by 5 into 5 divided by 5 is 5. So minus 21 minus 5 is minus 26. Minus 21 minus 5 is 26. Minus 26 divided by 25 minus 5, 20. So that is minus 1.3. So BXY is minus 1.3, where mean is 30 by 5, 6, and mean of Y is 40 by 5, 8. Hence, the regression equation is X minus 6, that is X minus X bar, mean is 6, and that is equal to minus 1.3. Minus 1.3 is B XY, right? Y minus 8, that is Y minus Y bar. So the equation is X is equal to, so X6 is brought to the right hand side of is equal to, so X is equal to 16.4 minus 1.3Y. This is the regression equation for X on Y. And we will find out regression equation of Y on X. That you can mark it as 1. And Y on X is equation 2. So in the same table, we have these values. From the same table, the values are taken here. That is, sigma dx dy is minus 21. Sigma dx is 5 and sigma dy is 5. Same, sigma dx square is 45 and sigma dx whole square is 5 square. So simplifying that, we get minus 0.65. So byx is minus 0.65. Hence the regression equation is y is equal to 11.9. minus 0.65x. This is second equation. So now we will calculate the correlation. So correlation is equal to root of bxy into byx. That is minus 1.3x into minus 0.65 is 0.845 under root, that is 0.9192 is highly fair degree of correlation exists, positive correlation exists. That is the conclusion. So here we have seen how to calculate regression coefficients, how to get regression equations, and how to calculate correlation from regression coefficients. All these things we have seen in this example. We will see the properties of regression coefficients. Both the regression, now we have calculated the formula problem. So from that problem, we will see the regression coefficients properties. both the regression coefficients will have the same sign. So same sign should be there for regression coefficients. Either they will be positive or negative. The coefficient of correlation will have the same sign as that of regression coefficients. So whatever the sign we get for regression coefficients, the same will be for correlation also. And regression coefficients, both BXY and BYX should have same sign, that is minus or plus. For two variables, X and Y, there are two regression equations. That is regression equation of X on Y and regression equation of Y on X. This is already seen. Of course, I am repeating now. The regression line of Y on X gives the most probable values of Y for given value of X. The regression line of X on Y gives the most probable value of Y, values of X for given values of Y. This already we have seen. Now, regression equation of X on Y. X minus X bar is equal to R into standard deviation of X, standard deviation of Y. So, X bar is equal to mean of X series and Y bar is equal to mean of Y series. And R into standard deviation of X by standard deviation of Y is called regression coefficient of X on Y. And X on Y is denoted by BXY. Right? And regression equation of X on Y, deviations taken from actual mean. As earlier we have seen deviations taken from assumed mean. Now we will see deviations taken from actual mean. So if the deviations are taken from actual mean, we need not calculate coefficient of correlation again, sigma xy by sigma y square. Right? So x is equal to x minus x bar, y is equal to y minus y bar. And when it is taken from assumed mean, this is the formula. This we have already seen. Just to remind you, to revise you, I have given this one. Again, if you go through this again and again, then you will understand perfectly. So y minus y bar is equal to r into standard deviation of y by standard deviation of x, that is x minus x bar. R standard deviation of y by standard deviation of x is called regression coefficient of y on x. And it is denoted by the symbol BYX. And regression equation of regression coefficient of y on x is R standard deviation of x by standard deviation of y or sigma xy by sigma x square. If the deviations are taken from assumed mean, this is the formula, right? BYX is equal to this one. Now we will work out a problem for this so that you can easily understand. So correlation coefficient is what we have seen early, right? And R is equal to BXY into BYX. Steps to be followed is, first you write the problem XY, then you take product, the sum of sigma X, sum of sigma Y, and then you take deviations from actual mean in the third and fourth column. Then in the fifth column, X square, and the sixth column, Y square, seventh column, XY. All these columns are total. To get the totals of all the columns, then we will substitute the values in the formula. So these are the steps what I have explained you. So after obtaining these values, we will substitute these values in the formula, right? Substitute the above values in the formula. Now taking example from the data given below, the two regression equations, the coefficient of correlation between the marks in economics and statistics, and the most likely marks in statistics when marks are economics, marks in economics are 30, we have to find out. These three we have to find out. So the problem is marks in economics X, marks in statistics Y. Then X is economics and Y is statistics. So data is given here. So calculation of regression equation and coefficient of correlation is X bar is equal to sigma X by N and Y bar is equal to sigma Y by N. That is, these two columns are added to get this values. So mean of X is 32 and mean of Y is 38. Now we'll draw a table and X and Y are taken, from which we have taken deviations. And we have squared the deviations and we have found out the product of deviations, that is XY. So all the columns are added, just as I said, all the columns are added. And then we'll take the values in the formula. So regression equation of X on Y is X minus X bar is equal to BXY into Y minus Y bar. So sigma XY is equal to minus 93. Sigma Y square is equal to 398. So the value of BXY is minus 0.2337. So this is the equation. X is equal to minus 0.2337. Y plus 8.8806 plus 32 is brought to the right hand side, so plus 32, that means minus 0.2337 Y plus 40.8806, right? Now we will find out the regression equation of Y on X. This is first equation. This is equation number one. Similarly, the regression equation of Y on X is calculated. And now Y minus Y bar is equal to BYX into X minus X bar. The formula is substituted with the values and we get equation. Second equation is Y is equal to minus 0.6643 plus 559.257. So in the problem, economics marks are given and statistics marks we have to find out. So substitute these values and find out statistics marks. So we are taking in the second equation, Y is equal to, that is statistics is equal to minus 0.6643 plus 643 X plus 59.257. That is 0.6643 into 30 minus 19.9290 plus 59.252. That is 39.3286. Or if it is rounded off, because it is marks, it is rounded off 39 marks. For economics, 30, statistics will be 39 likely. So calculating the correlation, PXY into BYX under root, it comes to 0.394. Hence, the correlation is 0.394. It is not minus, it is plus 0.394. Because minus into minus is plus. Right. We'll take another example. 8 years of life, that is x is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And weight is 5, 7, 8, 10, 15, 17, 20, 22. So estimate the weight of a kid at the age of 4 years and calculate the both equations. Both lines means both equations. So this is the actual formula we have to use. Y minus y bar is equal to byx into x minus x bar. And y minus y bar. Sorry. Here mistake is done. Y on x is y minus y bar. This is x minus. Right, so the solution is mean for x series is 4 and mean of y series is 13. Bxy is equal to sigma xy by sigma y square and byx is equal to sigma xy by sigma x square, where x is x minus x x bar and y is y minus y bar. So taking table, all the sums will be taken. Sigma x is equal to 32, sigma x is equal to 0, small x is equal to 0. Like this we have to take all the products, all the summation, and then from the table the values are substituted in the equations like this. And we will calculate the regression coefficients. So regression coefficients are 0.458 and 2.167. So x equation is x is equal to 0.458 y minus 5.94954 plus 4. Plus 4 is taken on the right side. So this is the first equation. And second equation is y is equal to 2.167 x plus 5.668 after substituting the values byx and y bar x bar. So 4 years age kid estimating the value of y is 14.336, that is 14. So you can round off the value 14. For 4, it is 14. So the weight of a kid at the age of 4 is 14.34, or 14. You can take 14. So coming to the summarizing part of this lesson, regression coefficient should not be greater than 1. So calculation of correlation coefficient is possible through regression coefficients. That is also we have seen. R standard deviation of x by standard deviation of y, or R into standard deviation of y by standard deviation of x coefficients are calculated by taking this sigma xy by sigma y square or sigma xy by sigma x square, those coefficients. And for shortcut method, dx dy is used. And formulas for finding the regression equations through regression coefficients, we have seen x minus x bar is equal to b xy into y minus y bar, or y minus y bar is equal to byx into x minus x bar, like that. So coming to the assignment part, we have some theory questions and problems. Uses, of course, we have seen in the last lesson. You can write, and remaining are related to this lesson. So 60 is the problem. You please try out with all the methods, that is direct method, actual mean method, and assumed mean method, all the three methods. And you will appreciate the time taken and method of calculation, so that you can understand which method is very easier to work out. And we have some other problems, 7th, 8th, and 9th. So 4 problems are there and 5 theory questions are there. You can attempt all these things and you can submit the assignment. So thank you very much. We'll meet in the